Year 1 and 2's production of A Present for the Baby. Please could you make sure that your mobile phones are switched off? Thank you.
You can read well.
A long time ago, a lady called Mary and a man called Joseph went to Bethlehem. They stayed in a little stable, and in that stable a very special baby was born. He was called Jesus.
There were many animals in the stable to keep Jesus warm. Let's meet some of them.
Mary and Joseph were very happy to have their new baby, but Jesus wasn't happy at all. He cried and cried and cried. Nobody could make him happy, and nobody knew what to do.
I know what to do. The baby didn't need a present.
Good idea. I'll find some rich who can give him a really good present.
I can give him a present.
You're just a little boy, and a little present is no good.
The messengers went and found a true prince, a fine queen, and a great nobleman.
Thank you.
before the elephants but he kept on crying. He cried and cried and cried and cried. The messengers set out to search again.
This time they went to see all the very finest singers in the land. They formed a mighty choir. The choir decided not to see Simon Cow, but went to see the baby. And they sang for Jesus a very grand song indeed.
dancers danced and danced, but still the baby cried and cried, the messengers left the stable.
The messengers didn't know what to do next. Then they saw the little boy again. you so much for listening to our play. We hope that you all enjoyed it.
So many other people in the way, it doesn't matter.
Oh,
is.
Now I've got bells.
He's got Ryan's thing, but he's lost the shape somewhere. Sorry.
And this is the memo that he's the nativity.
Hello, Joshua.
The wise men are keeping well out of it.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
We welcome you all to our preschool nativity. We hope you'll enjoy it. Here goes. Many years ago, an angel came to a woman called Mary and told her that she would have a baby and that she would name him Jesus. He would be the Son of God. Soon after, Mary and her husband Joseph had to leave their home in Nazareth and travel to Bethlehem to be counted with all the other people in the region. It was a long, hard journey, and Mary rode her donkey while Joseph walked beside her.
Well done, Tom.
say something to you about Christmas. Do you know what these are? Lots of these cards. Do you know they were my birthday cards?
Yeah.
Because my other guy had a birthday.
Yeah.
And you get cards, I'm sure, when you have a birthday. Let me read you what it says on this one. It says, I think you're the greatest. There's no better to be had. There's no one who compares with my super dad. That's nice, isn't it? I'm going to keep that one because I like it. And your birthday, it's really nice to get cards and to know that everybody's thinking about you. Well, you know, Christmas is the birthday of Jesus. And that's why we celebrate Christmas, to remember his birthday. And so we can't send Jesus a card, but we can think about him. And we can remember that Christmas is the time when we celebrate the birth of Jesus. That's why we send each other cards. We can't send him a card, but we send one another a card, and we remember Jesus' birthday that way. So thank you for coming here. Thank you for sharing with us your nativity. Thank you for dressing up so beautifully, because we've got some beautiful angels and some very wise men and kings and some lovely stars and some shepherds who have been looking after their sheep. So thank you very much. Let's give them another round of applause.
Happy Christmas. Oh, walk past me. Hello, Tom. Tom, look.
What are all these?
What's this? What? What's over here? What? Oh.
Santa's ate all the mince pie. He must have liked it then.
He must have done. It's all gone, isn't it? Yeah.
Maybe because of all the other carrots and potatoes.
Maybe. But look, have we got any presents over here? Let me see. Wow. Yes, we do. Look at all those presents.
Oh, no.
Wow.
Look at all these presents.
Wow. Is there any presents there, Tom?
It's amazing.
Last year we had Less than that, didn't they?
What's
Dad?
There, Tom? Is it presents?
No.
Yeah. Excellent. Well, shall we open some up?
Yeah. Can we get your sacks?
You want to get your sacks? That's Rebecca's name on. Oh, Thomas.
Is
it heavy? Thomas, look at the size. That's nearly as big as you. Look at the size of that. Goodness me.
Isn't that the size of mine?
Strong boy.
Yeah.
Turn the light up a bit. Oh, man.
Very dark. Oh. I couldn't see what I was doing. Oh, what's that?
Can I open it?
You can open them. Who's that, Tom?
Shrek!
Shrek!
I've got some princess
What have you got, Becca? Oh, for you, is that for your bed? Wow! What have you got, Tom? Who's that? Wow!
He wanted one of them, didn't he?
Show us, Tom.
Show Mummy. Show Mummy. Show Mummy. No, go back. Go back, that's it. Yay!
Mummy, one for me.
Wow! Yeah! Okay, put him down. You can open some more. No, Thomas! In your bag! Have a look in your bag, fella. No, that's just a present.
Thomas!
Look where Rebecca's looking.
In your sack, Tom.
Got some more.
What's in your sack, Tom?
And what's...
He's just opened the wrapping paper that I got. And now I'm opening the wrapping paper that's...
It says 7:24 on this video recorder. This is an hour out. We need to adjust it. It's actually 6:24 for the record. Just so you know. Oh, it's another present, Tom. What's that, Rebecca? What's Rebecca got? Ooh!
Some trousers.
Some nice clothes. Well, pockets at the back, I think.
Okay, at the back.
Yeah. Very nice. Well done. Leave them on the chair. Can't you do it, Tom? Daddy help you?
Yeah.
Daddy get you going. Okay. Here you are, fella. There you go.
Daddy, are these all from you without the names on?
Sorry, Father Christmas. We get them and Father Christmas delivers them for us. What have you got there, Tom?
Elbows.
Show Mummy.
Incredibles.
No, I don't think he said Incredibles. Did he say Incredibles?
Incredibles.
Wow, what's that?
Wow.
What's that, Tom?
Where that?
Da-da-da-da.
No, Tom, that one's wrong.
Thomas, it's out of your bag. That's it, yeah.
I'm so
excited. What could that be? What could it be?
A doggy.
What?
A doggy.
A doggy?
A doggy?
A doggy.
Donkey? You think it's a donkey? Oh, not sure. What have you got there, Rebecca? A book?
Princesses are not...
Quitters. Princesses are not quitters. A little book to read there. That's good. Thomas, what's that? What is that, Tom?
Couch.
It's a dressing gown. And who's on your dressing gown?
Shrek.
Show Mummy.
Wow, look at that. You want to put it on?
Come here, put it on like Mummy and Daddy. And Becca.
Hey, Mum, Daddy.
What have you got there?
Tiny
bags. Oh, tiny little bag. What could be in there?
I know what this is. I know what it is.
Oh, careful, don't break them, whatever they are. Oh, hey, hello, Shrek. Hello, Tom.
Let's see. All those little ears.
You've got little ears as well.
Thomas, let's see.
Tom, show Mummy. Ta da!
Oh.
Now, do it again, Tom. Tom. Do it again.
Stand still.
Look at Mummy. Wow, you could wear them at church, couldn't you?
And I could wear them, the red one, at Four Rainbows now, can't I? The red ones.
They're really Christmassy. I don't think you don't want to spoil them at Rainbows, do you?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Might be
More? Really?
I've got more as well.
Fantastic.
Yay.
What you got in there, Tom?
Oh, wow.
What's Father Christmas book?
Yeah.
Oh, what's that? Is it a hat? I don't think it's a hat.
No, I think it's a book.
What have you got there, Becca? Oh, it dropped out the bottom.
Oh, cool.
What are they? More pink trousers. Oh, you'll look nice in those. Who's Balamori, Tom?
Balamori.
Yeah, well, that's right. Why don't you put them on? Yeah, yeah, we'll get open it in a minute. Any more presents, Thomas?
I've got loads more presents.
Okay. Oh, jingle, jingle, jingle.
More?
I've got fantastic.
More of that.
What have you got then? Oh, you got another. Oh, what could that be? No, it's not rattling.
That's what the teacher did.
Is it, teacher? We got a box there, Tom, haven't we? Go on, open it up.
Oh, cool, we've got a Balamori thing.
Mmm.
Oh, cool, we've got
some
things.
Yeah? Oh, cool.
What have you got, Tom?
Say, Mummy.
What have you got, Tom?
CDs.
CDs to listen to.
I could put them in my thing once.
Maybe.
One more.
Daddy, I can't open this. It's got too many sellotape.
Has it been done up too well, has it?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, okay. I'll give it to Mummy.
Can you open it?
Oh. Elves, wrap this up well.
Well done.
I know what it is.
What's that?
The Lion King 2 Simba's 5 DVD.
DVD to watch. Fantastic. Oh, Tom, what you got there? You're doing very well with the unwrapping this year, Thomas, I must say.
Shoes.
Slippers? And who's on your slippers? Shrek. Oh, they go off. Look, they glitter.
You're going to put them on, Tom?
Daddy, that came off something.
What's that, Tom? Okay.
It's just a little note from you.
Yeah, that's to know that Father Christmas gave them to you. That we gave them to you, Father, for Father Christmas.
It's about this big, isn't it? It's still there today. Renee was the second beautiful daughter of Percy and Annie Tilton. Grandma's early years were spent being educated, I think, at Evington Street School. Thank you. Sunday mornings, Mum attended the Ebenezer Street Baptist Chapel in Lily Road, opposite the recreation room. Mum soon dropped the Renee name tag and is still known to this day to her friends and family as Vera or Mum. Now, as Mum was growing up into her early years, especially her teenage years, music became a very big part of her life. Percy Tilton, her dad, played the mandolin, and Mum was greatly encouraged to play the piano accordion. She would attend music lessons each Saturday in the music shop in King Street, Hammersmith. Some evenings after tea, especially Sundays, Percy and Mum would play together in the front room. One of Percy's favourite tunes was Little Brown Jug. I believe that's right. Percy Tilton was part Italian, so to be musical in this way was a very typical trait. Percy also played the ocarina. For those of you that might not know what the ocarina is, it looks like a sweet potato, but it's made of china clay with holes along. It's played like a recorder. His wife Annie didn't like this instrument at all. Annie complained loudly. "Put that bloody thing away," she would say. "If you don't, I'll chuck it in the dustbin." If Annie Tilton was asked to explain what an ocarina really would be like, her reply was, "It's two pieces of catgut stretched across the cat's arse, plucked with the tongue." This was a very rare emotional outburst on her part, because she was really a very prim, proper, grown lady. Mum's accordion playing won her the coveted talent show competition at the Palais de Danse Hammersmith in Shepherd's Bush Road. Mum played cruising down the river on a Sunday afternoon. It brought the house down and won her first prize. Mum left school at about 14 years of age, went to work in a factory in Fulham Palace Road, opposite Chancery Road, the Rifle Park. The place was named the Civic Factory. There she made munitions for the forces. Later on, she met Dad. He was a firefighter. He was a firefighter stationed at Finley Street School that had been part commandeered as a fire station because it was wartime. Fulham, like most of other central London towns, were being bombed every night. So the Civic Factory in Fulham Street, Hammersmith, their workers and mum were evacuated to Ayr in Scotland. It was here that she made long life friendships with Lily and Bill Ray, and Gabby, a nice lady from Belgium. But soon after, Dad got his call-up papers and served in the RAF in South Africa, Rhodesia, Egypt and Palestine. Do you notice a pattern here? Everywhere that Dad went, internal fighting or war broke out. During all these dark days, Mum and Dad sent each other regular love letters, of which I have seen and read, and I am inspired by.
Watch out, me.
Mum's only other love, apart from in her life, was the singer Max Bygraves, who she still loves to this day. But she still loves that best. Mum married Dad in a church on the corner of Fulham Palace Road and Harford Street on the 27th of July 1946. On the 14th of August 1948, Brian was born. On the 1st of May 1953, Pat was born. On the 14th of August, again, 1957, Ray was born. I think we can explain those events as one cold summer night and two sub-zero freezing nights. On a very cold firework night in November. Mum and Dad worked hard and brought us all up to be loving parents of our own children that are here today. And he also brought us up to be useful citizens in the world. I remember Mum enjoying afternoon cups of tea with a biscuit and a chat with her mum while I listened to the latest episode of Mrs. Dale's Diary in 29 Elm Street. We remember Mum working at Marks and Spencer's, Duckham's, Courtauld's, and on Saturday nights at the White City Tote. But first and foremost, she was always putting us children as the number one priority in her life. Now the big question, what is Mum really like? Multifaceted, I would say. She is a good cook, she bakes cakes, can do knitting and sewing. She likes a laugh and a joke. Mum likes holidays by the sea and in the countryside. Mum likes whole nut chocolate, and chocolate will not whirls.
I said, hold up.
Mum likes red shoes, but would never buy them, and certainly not wear them. Mum really loves her 9 grandchildren and 8 great-grandchildren. And we hear of others as it were in the pipeline. Well done to those guys and girls. What does Mum hate? Mum hates nothing, it's too strong a word. But she dislikes cricket, snooker, athletics,
yay,
and most televised sporting events. She detests dentists, drumming and loud discos. During her married life, Mum made Dad 9,100 work lunches, 11,380 dinners, and uncountable cups of tea and cakes. Mum overcame fear of heights, of anything that rose higher than a Victoria sponge cake, by flying to America and back on a huge aeroplane to be part of an enjoyable family wedding. Recently, Mum enjoyed being the guest of honour with her late sister's family, celebrating the christening of the 5th generation of girls to be born in her family. A very rare happening in any family event. But most of all, Mum is patient, kind, loving, forgiving, a faithful friend. Mum stores feelings, memories, and cherishes the love shown to her by family and friends. Mum keeps all of this in her heart. Very much more. Raise your glasses to a wonderful lady.
Yeah.
That has reached
joking.
At 65, I'm told, no one wants you. When you're 18, you're a beautiful auntie. Wonderful.